In the late 1980s, aerospace engineer Ron Evans was working in the defence industry in Lancashire. He'd been trying to find a way to detect stealth bombers using fluctuations in gravity. And he wondered if he could take it even further. Could he use gravity to levitate a plane? Ron's employer was the biggest defense and aerospace contractor in Europe, BAE Systems.
Let's be clear that not everyone in the company thought we should be doing it. And some very senior people that felt, okay, let's just have a little look at the future. And the concept became known as Green Glow.
If just one idea works even only partly, you won the jackpot.
At around the same time in the US, NASA began a parallel project.
It was around 1996 when I was asked to lead the Breakthrough Propulsion Physics Project. Things like non-rocket space drives, interstellar propulsion,
and manipulating gravity,
things like that. I can't go in there to talk about it now because NASA's not doing that work right now.
We asked them whether we could go there and talk to them about it, and they just said no.
Dr. Eugene Bokletnov had been using a machine called a cryostat to cool electrical superconductors. And something very strange happened.
And one of my colleagues, who was living at that time, just came to the laboratory and said, "Guys, what are you doing here?" And he was smoking his pipe. And he blew his pipe over the cryostat, and the smoke went close to the cryostat, hit some unseen barrier, and very fast went up.
After months of investigation, Bokletnov concluded that what he created was an anti-gravity field.
This gravity field is, in our case, repulsive. And as you can see, the repulsive force is pretty big.
Out of the blue, from the MOD, I got a letter asking me what I made of the Bokletnov withdrawn paper. Well, at the time, I didn't know what to make of it, not a lot.
So this guy had the idea that by, you know, messing around with superconductors, he could change the strength of the gravitational field. Crap.
From Einstein's perspective, a mass actually distorts the fabric of space and time, or space-time as it's called. That distortion is rather like a well. So here's another object that's moving nearby our mass that has bent space-time, and as it goes past, it bends towards the massive object.
One of the big theoretical objections to gravity control was always that, unlike electromagnetism, gravity had no negative form.
But a negative mass would be, in our analogy here, something like a mound instead of a depression. And then you run into problems.
If Clifford Johnson and other theoretical physicists are right, anti-gravity propulsion will remain an unworkable dream.
Gravity is a subject we don't know about. That's why we're exploring it.
But today, he's been invited to witness a unique gravitational breakthrough using quantum engineering.
So what we have here is our quantum gravity gradiometer. Atoms are sensitive enough to detect the mass of my body at a range of about 1 meter.
So your gravitational field is affecting this device?
Yes.
Getting into the quantum, that's really allowing us to do things that were just unbelievable 30 years ago, that we've got something. Certainly I see this as a start.
For Ron Evans, gravity control is just something we haven't learned to do yet.
I'm sure we will one day. It's just a matter of time.